That's right, ladies and gentlemen. Frog Fractions. This might be a little ugly to start off with, because I may need to do some adjusting. So, well, I wasn't expecting that. Oh. That's what I needed to do. That is, well, let's clean this up a little bit, shall we? Come on. I think that's the... Let's bring that up. Alright, now... Actually, you know what? I think that's gonna be good enough. Actually, you know what I will do then? Since I'm not gonna try and blow this thing up all the way. Let's get rid of all the white. Make this a little bit bigger. Wow, I look really washed out. Is that just the natural lighting? Yeah, let's not have that on. I look super washed out. The peel! Alrighty. So, Frog Fractions. How's the sound? I had to go into the mixer and adjust things because it was super, super loud. But if it is good, I'm just gonna play. My soul is not ready for this. Cybernetic brain? Anything your regular old frog brain can do, this newfangled cybernetic frog brain can do better. Cost 8 Zork mids. Too expensive? 8 fruit? Fuck, what? What is anything? What? Turtle. Upgrade your lily pad to a turtle friend. You can ride him over to grab fruit off the side. Who put that fruit there anyway? Durians. Upgrade your fruit to durians. They smell awful, so bugs will take longer to eat them. Staticling tongue. Rub balloons against your tongue before extending it. Nearby bugs will stick to one another. Science. Home. Oh my god! Just... too many bugs! What is life? Oh, sweet mother of Jesus! Okay, too expensive. I don't have enough. Okay, I got a turtle. Okay, this might be nice. Okay, that's actually going to be a little helpful. Oh, dang it. What is any of this? Wait, what? 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 Ah! What? Wait, so I have to pay to uninstall an upgrade? Okay, well, the static tongue should have been something I picked up, like, immediately. Holy crap, okay. What is this? Upgrade my turtle friend to a dragon? What do you have me playing? Wait, what? What? Now it's a bullet hell? What? What the fuck? What in the actual fuck? Wait, what? What? What is going on? Install a warp drive on your flying dragon. Now he will really take you places. What is happening? What? What is going? No! What? I gotta shoot! What is? Oh god damn it, Mike! Wait, what? What'd I do? Now it's a Christmas tree? Oh god. Oh god, there is no amount of anything that prepares you for this. Wait, what? What? Is that? What is going on? Wait, what? 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 What the fuck is going on? Oh, okay. Mr. Hop, the charges against you are severe. You're accused of breaking and entering into our native habitat, Bug Mars, with the intent to purloin our delicious space fruit. How do you plead? Amphibious, Your Honor. Wait, what? What? I don't know. Sure, I'll be a bug, why not? Excellent, all you need to do is pass a test on the history and culture of this fine planet. Shall we begin? Our bug flag has 4 bug stripes. What do they represent? Bugs? A little bit on the nose, isn't it? You can blame Bug Betsy Ross for that one. Next question. On the series Bug Jersey Shore, what is Bug Snooki's favorite ice cream? Well, I had to try, didn't I? 420 bugs ago, Bug in Chief Bug Thomas Jefferson wrote in the Declaration of Bugs that we are blessed with which inalienable right? As the revered document says, the only right you'll ever need. During the War of Bug 1812, General Stonewall Bug Jackson held off the nefarious Frog Armada single-handedly. How many mecha frogs did he crush under the wheels of his Mercedes bug? Sure, let's go with the pot reference. A shameful moment in our history. He regretted it for the rest of his life. Last question, Mr. Hop. How do you feel about fractions? Spoken like a true bug. I'm impressed, Mr. Hop. Yours is the first perfect score our fake naturalization program has ever had. We were going to fire you into the sun, but instead we've decided to issue you a work visa. If you'll just sign here. A Bartholomew... Oh, God. Chitin donor? Sure, why not? Wait, what? What? Now I'm back here? But just on Mars. And I'm missing gifts. I need Zork mids! How do I get Zork mids? Can I go down like I did last?
As conceived in 1632 by Portuguese printing press operator André Felipe, boxing was a gentleman's game, in which two men would square off and regale each other with stories monotonous for days on end, until one of them fell to the ground from boredom or exhaustion. Over the next few years, the new sport developed a respectable following of a few hundred local socialites.
Sure. Okay. Let's see how far this rabbit hole goes. Oh god, there's a fork in the path.
It was Felipe's son, Andre Felipe Felipe, who developed what he called the punching strategy in 1637 after seeing a schoolboy strike another in anger, causing him to fall down. When Andre Felipe Felipe challenged the then champion, British expatriate Sleepless Bill Bishop, to a match, Bishop was the odds-on favorite. You can imagine his surprise when, while he was describing what he had had for breakfast that morning, Andre walked up and thumped him in the neck, sending him down for the count in the parlance of our time.
Thank you.
was universally agreed that the boy had violated the spirit of the game. Officials were unable to find any actual rule that punching violated, and were forced to let the victory stand. This upset caused an uproar in the boxing community large enough to spill over into local newspapers, which drew the interest of many outsiders to come see what all the fuss was about. The newcomers were enthralled to engage in these borderline barbaric displays of human strength and skill, and the rest is history. After a few spoiled sport school moms, single-minded about safety, added the padded gloves, of course.
There are so many emotions running through me right now. I don't know what to feel.
Today's boxing enthusiasts fantasize about a newcomer that would rock the ring the way Felipe did. Calcification of the modern rule set has essentially locked the punching strategy into place, but it's easy to get caught up in the fantasy. Young scholars with big dreams often enter the ring with their crazy new trick, usually a variant of hypnosis. And though they've achieved the occasional victory, none of the gimmicks have been robust enough to make it to the big time. The real wonder, though, is that Andre Felipe's original vision of boxing is still around. Gentlemen's boxing clubs can be found in cities all over the world. You can visit one most any day of the week, and see two erudite gentlemen exchanging pleasantries in the ring. Most people only come to watch a few hours of a match, and then leave. But every once in a
while, this is the face of a lot.
A stout fellow. A die-hard fan.
Though confusion is a pretty big chunk of what I'm feeling right now.
Who for love of the sport must stay to witness the last glorious seconds of wakefulness slip away, only to return to fight again another day.
Oh, you're fucking shitting me. You're fucking shitting me. Is that it? The rumbling seems to have stopped and you feel the intense downward pressure letting up. After a moment, you calm down enough to start taking in your surroundings. For the first time since the seemingly dormant vessel sprang to life. Command module. The walls of this circular room curve to meet at a point that must correspond to the curved nose of the outer hole. Lining the walls, you see a porthole. You see a porthole, a glowing display, and a control deck. A ladder leads aft. porthole? Look at porthole? What next? Look at porthole. Oh. Through the porthole you can see a background of stars shifting as the ship gently spins. You know what? I fucking hate you guys. What else did I have? Porthole. Look at glowing display. Use glowing display. I'm spelling it right.
McLean, D-I-S.
Go to glowing display. Okay, so the glowing display is not something I can interact with. Oh God, I can't go up? What was the other thing? I don't remember what the other thing is. I can't go up. Okay, help. Look around. Examine. Ball? What? Get wrench, turn knob. Read pamphlet, pour orange juice into glass. Finally remember the adventure. If it's possible to do, it must be good and wise. I'll try that. Oop. Nope. Just typing in display doesn't do anything. Open box. Well, fuck you too, game. Climb stairs. Look. Okay. Use ladder. You'll have to be more specific as to what you want to do with the ladder. Go up ladder. There we go. You climb across the ladder. This looks like an all-purpose living area. A sleeping pod sits next to a nightstand. A ladder leads to the floor, and an oriental rug lies in the center of the aft wall. Look. Can I just do rug? This decorative oriental rug sits in the center of the room. Looking at it more closely, it doesn't quite lay flat on the floor. There's a significant dip in the middle. Move rug. Oop. Not Moe. Move rug. Moving the rug, you discover a recessed hatch below it. Your score has gone up by 2. Look. Hatch. The hatch is sealed tight. A spoked wheel protrudes from the center of the hatch. Look. Wheel? Turn wheel. You have to work at it a bit, but after you give the wheel a few good spins, the hatch pops open. Look, hatch! The hatch is open. Enter hatch. Engine room. Nearly every surface in this room is covered with a thick, sticky purple gloop, which seems to be thicker near the gray machine sitting in the corner. A hole in the wall exposes a nest of wires. There is a hatch leading back to the captain quarters in the fore. Look goop. Look machine. The machine consists of a spigot aimed at the flat platform A handwritten sheet of paper has been hastily taped over the base of the platform. Look. Paper. This is the out-of-order note, including with your game package. Touch goop. That seems to be fixed in place. Lick goop. I'm not hungry. Rub goop. Collect goop. Use hatch. Enter hatch. Look sleeping pod. The sleeping pod looks like a bed with a lid, but you have to assume it's got some sort of suspended animation functionality. I mean, right? There's a hole on top. Next to a gauge reading empty. Enter sleeping pod. You can't safely sleep until you're confident you'll return to Bugmars by the end of the trip? The fuck? Look. Climb ladder. Oh. Wow, I can spell. Climb ladder. And a control deck. Move to the end. Control deck. Use control deck. Dude, my brain is so full of fuck right now. Like, holy crap. This is also my first time ever playing a text adventure, so this is going to be interesting. Okay. So, I'm not pissed at you yet. I'm just really confused. I'm trying to take stock of my emotions, yet still play this. Look, glowing. I think I've already done this one. Use glowing, DISPLAY. Lining the walls, you see a porthole, which I've looked at, glowing display. I don't know how to, even look at the glowing display. Look at glowing display. Fuck the glowing display. Go to control deck. Yeah, that's not a place I can go.
look display. The glowing green display shows a map of the galaxy with the destination you don't recognize marked. In an ETA about 3,000 years, looking closer, you see two on-screen buttons labeled Route Details and New Destination. The screen splits forth in a slew of steps such as spiral, spinward at sepathy system, far faster than you can fathom. Okay. New ATION. Well, fuck that one up. DISTION. Wait, no. Ah, spelling! TIN. ATION. Set new. STI. Destination. The nav computer dumps you into an interface so abstruse. I don't even know that word right now. I'm not even going to care. That before you even concisely process what's happening, you've hit the back button and you're in the main. Okay. climb ladder. Look. Pod. Look hole. You was it use hatch? Enter hatch. Okay. Oh, the wires! Look, wires. Peering into the exposed machinery, you see what looks like an empty coffee can that you're guessing doesn't belong there. Take can. You twist the can and it eventually comes loose, but you've ripped the insulation off the adjacent wire in the process and begins sparking as it comes in contact with the adjacent strut. You glance down at what you've taken. Huh. It really is a coffee can. Look can? An empty coffee can. Okay. So I have an empty coffee can. Wires are sparking. Look, note. Take note. You rip the note off, leaving a fluttering piece of electrical tape behind and revealing a control panel. Use panel. Look panel. Most of the control panel is rendered unusable by the sticky pink goop. You see a row of what like radio preset buttons, all but two of which are stuck. There's also a big red lever. None of these are legibly. All right, push button. The raise button clicks into place and the previous selected button pops out. Local currency, says the robotic voice. Push button. Mom's specialty. Jesus. Push button. Whoop. Oh, excuse me. Machine whirs, dispensing local currency. A voice says a thick stream of Zorkmids shoot out of the faucet, bounce off the plat, and skip. Pick up Zorkmids. You spend a few minutes gathering up the scattered Zorkmids. Cool. Push. Button. Pull. Lever. Machine whirs, dispensing mom's specialty. Pink goop streams out of the faucet, splashing against the platform, getting everywhere. A couple of drops land in your mouth, and you recognize the flavor bacon milkshake. Atmospherical anomaly detected. A different voice says, a whirring sound ensues, and the bulk of the goop stuck to the invisible vents, leaving just enough goop floating around. Collect goop. You can't get a meaningful amount just by collecting loose goop. Collect all the goop. Collect all goop. And the invisible vents, leaving just enough goop floating around to be gross and annoying. Atmosphere purified. Pull lever? Use can. Look. Included on here. I missed something when I lifted the note. On the right track now, but forgetting something I grabbed earlier. I only remembered the can and the note. What else did I pick up? Yeah, I'm holding a can, the out of order note, and the Zorkmids. So, use tape? Do you want to do tape wires? Nope, not take. Tape wires. Take tape. Oh my god. I've tried using the can. I don't know what combination of words I need to make the can work. Like, use can. I need to be more specific. Place can. I need to be more specific. So, what do I need to say to make the can work? Tape wires. Okay, so I've taped the wires. Groovy. Put cup on machine. God damn it. Pull lever. Okay. And the can of pink goop. Okay. So now I have this. I'm assuming I'm done here. Captain's quarters. Feeling a hatch. Yeah, so I have a can of goop, a bunch of Zork mids, and an out of order note. Goop pod. Eat goop. Fuck goop. Good show. Okay. Climb ladder. Walls. Goop. Control. Deck. Climb. Ladder. Damn it. Ladder. Look. Hole. Oh. Fill pod? Fill pod with goop. You bring the can close to the hole, and the hole sucks the pink goop right in. Nearby gauge fills up. Enter pod. Okay, so I filled that up. I still can't use the... So let's... I have a feeling I need to, like, go back and look at the destination and stuff. Climb ladder. Did I just spell that wrong? Ah, it's D-E-S. Wow. Set new. It's T-I-N-A-T-I-O-N. Have computer dumps you into an interface. On the main map again. Welp. This is why I don't play text adventures. climb ladder. Okay. Oh, look, nightstand. Open. Open drawer. Take an UAL. Look me in UAL. Manual for the nav computer and the command module. After leafing through it, you feel confident you understand how to use the interface well enough to set a route back to Mars. Climb ladder. Use display. Use control deck. I've just forgotten how to use this shit. There we go. Set new T-I-N-A-T-I-O-N. Set new destination. Ugh, fuck. Spelling is out the window right now. Set new E-S-T-I-N-A-T-I-O-N. Set new destination. Plot a course back to Bug Mars, the engines roar, and you feel G-force shift. The ETA reads 57 and 3/5 years, huh? You run a diagnostic and determine that the vast majority of the time is going to be spent through Bug Customs. Luckily, you can sleep through it. Climb ladder. Use pod. Enter pod. You lie down in the sleeping pod. You lie down in the sleeping pod, close the lid, and you drift off. Secure that in 57 and something years, you'll return to Bug Mars as a wealthy frog. When you wake up, you're clearly not in your sleeping pod. You blearily glance around to get your bearings, and you appear to have been sleeping on a harp-shaped bed covered in roses. A voice from the next room, awake already, a wispy human figure in the bedroom, in a bathrobe, and Crown walks in. She bends over and kisses you on the nose, and suddenly you feel your body shifting. Yay, she laughs and claps, and you realize that you've been transmogrified into a human. Cool. Wait, what? What? You awake with a start. What a horrible dream. You call your friend Dracky the Flying Drac. Just to talk to someone. Hello, Draggy says. You just had the worst nightmare, you explain the situation. I'm not sure that a support group for human bug eaters is really going to get much of a following, Draggy ponders. Maybe if we drummed up a little publicity first. I know just the PR agency. 5 minutes later, Draggy shows up at your door, dressed to the nines. He tosses a frog tuxedo at you. Put this on, baby. We're running for president. What the fuck? No, no. No. Flaps McQueen. And introducing You know what? No. Just no. Numerators and decimals!
Here's your bug coffee, Mr. President. Heavy on the cream.
Wait, what? Bug assist. 2 million Zork mints cost to produce bug porn. 10,000 Zork mints per megabyte. How many megabytes of porn do you wish to... What is it? 20,000 would require. How many Bahapa pads? Not 16? Okay, a zero then. What price do you wish to charge per... I don't know. Like 39? Bug seemed unaware of porn today? What? So what am I at 39 budget? How many Zorkmids do you want to order? Sure. What in the actual fuck? Drugging the water supply will pacify delinquent bugs, keeping them off the streets and out of trouble, and not coincidentally staying at home and watching porn. Port hot, bug axe, Zork mids. 2? Yes, 0? Add a lot of zeros? It'd be reasonable.
Relax. Just be yourself.
I don't know. 1,000. How many pop-up ads? Let's go 9. What price? 300.
Not you. It's my inability to distinguish you from prey.
What is any of this? The bug porn sensors are working today. There will be no bore. What? Porn. Yeah. Yeah, why not? Well, I don't know what I just bought. All right. Let's do 50,000. How many megabytes? I actually don't know. What? Bytes of bug porn do you wish to make? I thought I just did this. Let's make a lot. Okay, apparently I need to be reasonable. 3,000. Alright, let's do 300. How many pop-up ads? 5. 50.
Thanks, but I'm into ladybugs.
Okay, so presidential swimming pool is what I had in. Oh. Oh, it was a padlock. Adding padlocks to a storage warehouse should cut down on shrinkage. Wait, so now he's a turtle again? What the?
Thank you.
That was a thing. I don't know what I want. Do I want a drink of lemonade? Do I want to check the time on my phone? So, that was Frog Fractions. There is no amount of drugs you can take that will prepare you for that. Just FYI, the Frog Fraction soundtrack is available now. You can't see it, but there's a little notice here. If you missed your chance to contribute to the Frog Fractions 2 Kickstarter, you can still contribute by visiting the Slack Backer Center. Alternatively, you can purchase the Frog Fraction soundtrack. So, I'm pretty sure there's going to be a Frog Fractions 2. I'm not going to lie. Like, my heart hurts. Like, yeah, I feel pain right here. Like, if I just stop moving, just some call 911, because I don't think my organs know how to function, because my brain is so overloaded. Like, I'm not gonna lie, from an emotions feel, I think this takes the cake over Snake Eater. Cut. 135. 135. I can't even right now. I literally don't know what to do with my life. Like, it's wow. It's 3:06 and I almost just said it's 6:03. That's how fucked up I am right now. It's 3:06. I have... Is it 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11? I still have 8 hours. I'm probably doing the math wrong. I still have a long time to go. I don't know what to do. Like, I don't know, I could pull up Steam and figure something out. I could throw Mega Man Legends 2 in. I mean, that would be fun for me at least. I mean, I could just curl up in the fetal position for a couple hours. That might be helpful. Like, I might need to actually take a 5-minute break. I don't know how long it's been since my last break or how long we've been doing Frog Fractions for. But I think I might need to take a 5-minute break to collect myself. I don't know. I really don't know. There's no way you can prepare for that. Like, at the beginning I thought, okay, because I knew this was a parody game. Like, that was explained to me. But that was pretty much it. So I thought, okay, you know, I'm going to be, like, doing fractions and learning how to do fractions. No, it was missile command with a fractional score, which meant nothing. And then it devolved into all of that. Holy crap! I will admit, I kind of want to play Frog Fractions 2. Just because I need to know how they top this, because that was a thing. Anyway, I am going to take a 5-minute break. Thank you, Mendex, for giving me a runtime. I know it's only been an hour, but I don't have anything lined up now. Like, I literally do not know what I'm going to play. I'm going to be back. I'm going to try and keep it 5 minutes. If I'm not back in 5 minutes, I'm either still trying to figure out what I'm trying to play or blood is leaking from my ears. Yeah, I just need to take a break and soak all of that in. So I'll be right back, give or take 5 minutes. And I'll see what I can come up with. So please stick around. Thank you for joining me on that ride. That was a ride we took together. I'll be back.